Welcome to Soaping 101. This is the first in a two-part series on masterbatching. Masterbatching, a term that is derived from the plastics industry, is simply when additives are combined and dispersed in a carrier material. For soap makers, this is a time-saving technique. Today we will learn about masterbatching lye solution. So let's first review some safety procedures. When masterbatching lye solution, look for a container that is resistant to alkali and can withstand liquids at a high heat. Polypropylene number 5 is best, such as this Rubbermaid brand container. It has a melting point of 338 degrees Fahrenheit or 170 degrees Celsius. It is safe for temperatures up to 275 degrees Fahrenheit and 135 degrees Celsius. If you are unable to locate a polypropylene number 5 container, HDPE number 2 is a suitable alternative. It can withstand heat up to 248 degrees Fahrenheit or 120 degrees Celsius for short periods of time. I do not recommend any lower rated plastic for storing lye solution, but please do your own research. Begin by clearly labeling your container. We are creating a 50-50 lye solution concentrate, meaning we will use equal parts of water and lye. To keep the temperature and the fumes low, I have replaced room temperature water with ice water. We add the ice water to the container. Then an equal amount of sodium hydroxide. Be certain to stir well until all the crystals are dissolved. Allow it to cool to room temperature and store it in a locked cupboard. To prepare 50-50 lye solution in a recipe is quite easy. Let's use our Bastille one. Our formulation calls for 4.41 ounces of lye and 10.56 ounces of water. Our pre-made lye solution is 50% water and 50% lye. To determine how much to use, we double the lye in the formula. 4.41 times 2 is equal to 8.82. And we'll pour this amount into our measuring cup. Now in our cup, we are still short the correct amount of water. The next step is to subtract the lye weight from the formula water weight. 10.56 minus 4.41 is equal to 6.15. Therefore, we add the additional water to the pre-made lye solution. Pretty simple, right? You could also add 6.15 ounces of milk or any other liquid base. I advise that you only masterbatch enough lye solution that you can use within a week's time. And be sure it is sealed in an airtight container. When exposed to air, sodium hydroxide will lose its strength. If you have any questions, please leave them below. I will do my best to answer them as I can. Well, that's it for this week. Next time is part 2 of Master Batching, the oils. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next time.